First, Hitchings from Highland Reeds, talking about my new high resonance reeds. People ask me what's the difference between my standard bonstone reeds and the high resonance reeds. Functionality, there's no difference. So the air tightness, the air efficiency, the steadiness, the moisture resistance, the lasting, all these things are exactly the same in the high resonance reeds. So it has all the same qualities. So what's the real difference? They're not very much the same. However, of course, the high resonant reeds, you can always tell the high resonance because they come with the black plugs. So that's the one significance. The other thing I've changed recently, as well as the reeds, because I went through a major refurbishment of the tool, although it looks very similar, there's actually been quite a few characteristics changed on the body of the reed. But apart from that, I've also changed the bridles. So the bridles are now clear plastic, and they're bigger, and this gives a slightly broader sound. That makes it easier to adjust the bridles, but you do have to be careful when you're putting them in and out of your drawn stocks that you don't knock the bridle. There's two clear notches on the side, which gives you guidance where to keep the bridles in between to get the best sound. Now the bass drawn reed I've made slightly smaller, shorter, so therefore it can tune a wee bit higher, because this was one of the problems. But this is the characteristics now of both the standard reed and this reed. So what makes the difference? Well, the high resonant reed looks very similar, but it's made from a different material. So it's made out of a harder material. Now there's two things that happen with injected molding. The injected molding process is a hot liquid that is poured into a machine, creates this, and then it cools down. That causes shrinkage when it comes out. So the different types of materials shrink to different ways. So this is a harder material and it shrinks more than actually the other material I use in the standard reeds. Now, it creates two things. It's harder, and because it shrinks more, it has a slightly smaller diameter. So I'm not quite sure what creates this, whether it's the harder material or the slightly smaller diameter, but this reed gives more harmonics than the standard reed. Harmonics are what we need to be able to produce to get our bagpipe sounding well. The drones produce high harmonics. So if you start off by playing your pipes and you're just playing your chatter, you have a monotone. You bring your tenor drone in, there's your harmonic. You bring the bass drone in as the first harmonic, the tenor drone is the second harmonic. And there's also a baritone harmonic. Now, these are physical things you can see coming in, and you know that as you introduce the tenor, the sound gets broader, more breath to it, you bring the bass in, it gets bigger and wider. And then you have higher harmonics that are going up above your drones that you can't physically see, but you can hear them. I can hear them, and most people can hear them. And that's what gives you the enriched sound. Now when you get the harmonics right in your drones, you then can then get your chanter balance, you get resonance. So the more harmonics you have and the higher harmonics, the sweeter notes you get on the chanter. Now this involves a far more in-depth video and discussion than what we have time for here. So basically, these look exactly the same, but they do produce more harmonics, you can hear it, and it gives you more resonance then off the chanter. If you get resonance from your chanter with your drones, you get more projection, you get more sound, and a better sounding bagpipe. As I said, all the other functionalities are exactly the same. To finish off, I'll just pull up the pipes and let you hear the new reeds, but they're on market now, test them for yourselves.